Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of The Expanse. My name is Agent R, or Ryan, whatever you prefer. Here in the studio, we are going to be, we're going to be getting right into it. Last episode was a lot more, how should I put it, busy than episode two. We had the big reveal, I guess a couple big reveals, but one of the main ones being Naomi finally meeting with Philip. And yeah, it went about how I expected in terms of success rate. Didn't expect him to kidnap her. That was new, but I think as I mentioned in the last episode, it's within his range. Like I can see him doing something like that. I don't really know, outside of trying to use her as some kind of piece to use his leverage. I don't really know what the purpose is besides, you know, him wanting to maybe get back at her and him. This is him kind of lashing out a little bit, getting his emotions involved, and he's going to bring her to Marco, which will be another interesting reunion. And then we had the massive bombshell of Earth getting hit by one of the asteroids. Well, I guess meteor, or it turns into a meteor. I don't know the terminology exactly. I know that I think an asteroid is one that's in space, and then like a meteor is when it breaks the atmosphere. Anyways, not important. Earth is smacked by this giant invisible rock, essentially slips past our defenses, smashes into Earth. And that's where they leave the episode, of course, right? In a massive cliffhanger. So people are still after the protomolecule, and I made a prediction that that the Martians are utilizing, or I should say supplying Marco with this technology to divert Earth's attention away from Mars, who is making strides to acquire the protomolecule weapon. That's my working theory currently. So yeah, excited to get into this episode. This is where it should be picking up. I mean, so I got my coffee where I'm filming this. The mug for this morning I'm drinking out of is a retirement. Because you've given so much of yourself to the company that you don't have anything left to we can use. You don't have anything left we can use. Yeah, so retirement. Well, you're only retiring because you've given everything and we have no more use for you. So just a little motivational mug to start the day. So yeah, if you guys are ready, I'm ready. I'll see you in the video. All things considered, we're pretty lucky that that is just a piece. If a piece did that much damage, imagine what the entire rock would have done. I mean, Marco did this to destroy all of Earth, for sure.
You spent 10 years in the Marines. Navy cost me 20 in my marriage. Now I find out it's all for a bunch of crooks. How are you so fucking nonchalant about all this?
It's a good question.
I used to have a rat. I named her Mouse, and she was so smart. My mom told me she was dying. I sobbed for hours, and then I stopped. I was tired of being sad, and I had to do something.
So we're building a coffin for our dying planet.
Wow, what a great story in comparison that was. That was awesome. But it's true. Why are you so desensitized? Why are you not more emotional about this? I'm tired. It's not that I'm not sad. I'm tired. Tired of being sad. And that's a tough reality, especially considering like Alex had put it, they put so much dedication and pride in the idea of forwarding Mars and seeing what it is and what it's become. At some point you get over it. At some point, in the words of a wise man, you get busy living or you get busy dying.
The hell?
What is it?
Emergency flight restrictions from the UN.
We still don't have all the details of the impact.
Yeah, whoa!
It is unclear whether this is related to today's explosion on the Martian Parliament, which happened almost simultaneously.
Simultaneous attack on the MCU... On the Martian Parliament? Is like the faction of Mars working with to dismantle the current Martian regime? Like, is that part of it? Or was this known knowledge before? Because now I'm not even recalling that the plan was to attack just... I thought it was just to attack Earth and maybe I'm not seeing it. Maybe maybe I'm only perceiving the dream to be so big, and it's actually bigger than that. Oh my God, this is getting even worse now.
Amos Burton.
That's me.
Welcome to the pit.
The pit? How biblical.
No exchange of goods of any sort. We'll be watching, so if at any point you feel threatened, just raise your hand and we'll be right there.
Oh yeah, I was right.
Hey, Peaches.
Blockers every morning. Food through a slot in the door. Half hour walk around the yard. Breathe in. Breathe out.
That sounds horrible.
You said you weren't coming down the well. Why are you here?
Hesitation? That's new. Ish.
Did you come here to help me?
I guess I did.
You can't. No one can. Not every stain comes out.
What the hell is that?
Lockdown.
Why?
Is it another meteor? Holy shit, it is. Oh my God.
Christian.
What?
A second rock just hit Earth.
Where?
About 40 kilometers northwest of Philadelphia, and we've lost communication with New York.
We need to contact the UN-1.
Oh my God.
Fleet Command recommends that we head to Luna immediately until they can better assess exactly—
We're not going to Luna.
Nancy, the planet's under attack.
And I'm not abandoning it.
God damn it, man.
Casey.
Madam Avasarala.
You fattened me up for years with macarons. Now, listen.
Oh my God. Dude, I get the goosebumps, man.
God damn it.
Sir, I'm sorry she made me.
The rocks crashing down on Earth are covered in Martian stealth composites. That's why our spotters cannot see them.
Retask the watchtowers and the sentinels. Just do it.
Ma'am, get down.
Oh my God.
Holy shit. Oh my God. Oh my God. Okay. 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 Just need a second to calm down for a second.
Zamiya, you're clear for pickup.
We got the security alert.
What the hell is going on?
Oh, now it begins. Wait a minute. Something's off about the staff.
Something's wrong.
Get everyone out of there now! It's a trap! They're firing at us!
Holy shit! I knew it! Oh my God! Oh my God. Holy crap, dude. They killed Fred Johnson.
They're firing on us again!
Oh my God. They knew where she was. Of course, they knew where she was. Oh my God.
It's in my quarters.
That's what they're after. That's what they're after. Holy shit, the protomolecules in his room. Oh my God. Oh my God. What the hell is that? Stop shooting, it's obviously not doing anything. Okay. Okay. My theory that the Martians were using them is looking not wrong yet, but it's not quite how I thought. They're getting the protomolecule like the OPA are. I don't know if this is either a double cross on the Martians' possible double cross, or this is still a part of the plan. I'm not quite sure yet, but oh my God. They're gonna ram it into the station. Holden, be careful, man. Be careful. Oh my God. Hold him, don't cut your hand. Jesus Christ, dude. God damn it, man.
So, who is in charge down there now?
Still not clear.
What about the watchtowers?
The orders went out. They're being retasked. I'm sorry.
We did everything we could.
You did. I know I didn't fight hard enough. I know I was a coward. Thank you for not disagreeing.
The fight is not over.
It's never over. Oh my God. Oh my God. Three down, six more to go.
Speaking face to face again.
If it had been up to me, we never would have.
At least now that you're here, we as a family can celebrate the greatest victory in our people's history. Together. Now this I did want to be a surprise.
Oh my God, he's gonna show her what he did.
You did this?
It's everything we ever dreamed of.
You murdered millions innocent people.
I freed our people.
Marco's insane.
One hit would have been a triumph, but after three, the Inners will never perceive us as weak again. It's time to let the system know who we are. Naomi, welcome home.
Wow. Jesus.
Ready, boss man.
My name is Marco Inaros, and we are the ones responsible for striking our oppressors on Earth and Mars. No longer will Beltus be persecuted.
Oh my God.
We will lead the Belt to a new, better form. A more human form. Today and forevermore, we are free.
Oh my God. Holy sh! Marco is insane. He's crazy. Like, and I think he's blinded by this idea that they're gonna all live in harmony. Like, as long as there are people colonizing, there will be people that have more than others, and the people that don't have as much will want more, and thus conflict will ensue. It's just human nature. It's gonna happen. Wow. And then, I don't know, I feel like my theory that the Martians were behind this is not quite right. But who knows? I'm not so sold that I'm, you know, backing off from my theory, but at the same time, I don't see it the same anymore. Like, I can't see that. Because at first I thought the Martians were trying to go after the proto-molecule and they were using Marco's, like, want to destroy Earth, but then they attacked Mars, and, like, maybe the higher-ups are also, like, factioning off of Mars and using this time to maybe make a deal with Marco to then go into and colonize their own world, because they're similar in to the Belters in that they want their own planet and they want to be free, but they want an atmosphere type of deal. I don't know. I, at this point, I don't know. Oh my God, this episode was insane. Almost as insane as Marco. But freaking Fred Johnson got killed too. Like, oh my God, we're in a bad spot. I don't even know where we go from here. Like, what happens now? Like, they have the proto-molecule. Mars was attacked, Earth was attacked. I don't know. Now the Babbage, like, run, I don't even know, like, where that factors into the plan here. I don't know. I'm very intrigued to see what happens next. I hope you guys really enjoyed this episode. This was crazy. This is giving me season 3 vibes all over again. Wow. I don't have much else to say. This was an intense, crazy episode. And I can't wait to see more. Thank you guys for sticking around. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I'll see you in the next one.